Jeff Frick here from theCUBE. We are at the Bright Edge Share 14 conference at the Palace Hotel in San Francisco. I'm joined here by Darren Pleasants, Director of Global Customer Acquisition for Google. So welcome, thanks for stopping by.
Thank you, thanks for having me.
That's a lot of customers at Google. So what kind of customers are you responsible for acquiring?
We focus mostly on small and medium-sized customers, and these are basically companies that don't yet advertise online. And so my team's job is to go out and find these companies, work with them to introduce them to the world of online marketing, and then help them join Google and basically get onboarded with their digital marketing campaigns.
So for the folks that haven't joined yet and are not advertising online, what's been the main inhibitor? Why haven't they done it yet? Are they just not paid attention? Are they slow? Are they scared? What do you find from your customers?
It's a good question. I think, of course, it spans the spectrum from, you know, we get large brands that you and I would know that are advertising a lot on television and in print, and I think for a lot of them it's just inertia. They've been doing that for a long time and haven't really invested in understanding how to do online marketing. But then the other end of the spectrum are the small guys, the mom and pop stores that are spending most of their money on yellow pages or newspaper ads. And it's simple and easy, and for them I think there's a fear of the unknown. They just don't really know how online marketing works. So our job is to take that full spectrum of types of businesses and work with them to help show them what the power of online marketing can do for them.
So how do you get them started? What are the training wheels for these types of folks to really start to get introduced to to online marketing and then obviously to excel and start to get better at it?
Well, we start by just trying to understand what their goals are. Are they trying to drive new leads? Are they trying to bring phone calls into their call center if they have one? Drive traffic into their store? Just build awareness? Depends on what they're trying to do. And then depending on those goals, we work with them to understand which of the various digital marketing services out there is right for them. Do you want to do search marketing? Do you want to do display marketing? There's YouTube, of course, these days with video. All of which can play a pretty powerful role in how companies find and grow find new customers and grow their business. So we work with them to come up with a customized approach to using digital marketing to drive their business.
Okay, great. And so you are participating on a panel here, I believe?
I'm doing a keynote, a 20-minute keynote or so, and then participating on a panel.
Okay, exactly. So what is your keynote about for the folks that won't be here?
Yep. So two main themes. One, just talking about the trends in the industry, right? There's a major trend, of course, towards video. Just mentioned that a minute ago. Major trend towards mobile. Major trends towards apps. And so I want to illuminate that a bit more and put some dimension and talk about what are the implications for marketers as they think about a world that's migrating rapidly towards those three themes. And then I want to get a bit more tactical and share some ideas around what marketers in the audience can do to improve the quality of their mobile advertising, take advantage of video, think about the world of applications and what they can do with that. So it's a bit of high level and, you know, tactical.
Right. So I wonder if you can share some of those insights with us now, especially around the mobile, because that's completely changing things. And yep. Especially for the younger kids who don't like to go to the laptop and never have gone to a desktop. Yeah, you know, how is that changing, you know, kind of the customer experience and how you reach them as a marketer?
All you have to do is look at anybody's home today that has kids and you see exactly what you just described. Nobody is really on the laptop so much anymore. They're all on a mobile device. They're interfacing with multiple screens at the same time. And so that has profound implications for how marketers reach those individuals. This will be the first year ever that there are more people on a mobile device than on a desktop device. So we've, in a sense, hit that tipping point and transitioned over. So main implication then is, how do you think about the content you create and make sure that it's highly web-enabled, highly mobile-enabled specifically, and optimized for the mobile experience. And there's a lot of things.
What are the top two or three things you got to be thinking about
perhaps,
when you're doing mobile content?
For instance, what's the main call to action you want of that customer? So if you're Progressive Insurance, right,
okay,
you probably want someone to ask for a quote, right? Well, most websites, you have to scroll down and find what you're looking for. You know, Progressive done a great job. It's a giant button. It's the single biggest thing on the front of that web page. They completely optimized their website for mobile. You can't help but see what they want you to do, right? Most websites have not yet done that.
And are people, your customers, bringing in, you know, kind of mobile development teams to really start to think about the world in all these different devices? But then not only do you have, you know, you got the Android phone, you got your iPhone, you got a 7-inch tablet, a 10-inch tablet. You know, what's the impact of all these types of devices?
Yeah, you have to build content that basically works on all of those. So that is the key. And then also build content that allows a person to move between these devices. That's another one of the insights from the talk, is that it's often the case people will browse or research on one device and then choose to convert, either make a phone call or buy something on another device. And so most websites today are not set up in a way to allow a customer to start one place and then move to a different device and complete that same transaction, end up having to start all over again.
Right.
So the best companies out there are linking these together, making it easy for customers to jump between devices and continue the same experience.
Yeah, or even jump between applications within the same device.
Totally.
I mean, you know,
yep.
The little things like making the phone number actually work that you see on the web page, right?
Yeah, there's another one, call extensions, right? That's another thing. So many websites where a phone call would be a huge outcome they're desiring, they don't make it easy to make that phone call. So putting call extensions, big call button, push the button and off you go, right? That it's somewhat obvious to some extent,
right.
But the number
right.
of companies who do that is surprisingly low.
Is that right? So talk a little bit about the change in kind of search engine optimization in terms of driving traffic versus the content marketing that we're talking about here and how that's impacting not only obviously Google, who's at the head end of all of those processes, but more importantly for the customers that are trying to reach their audience.
Yeah, I think it's, you know, the reality is we found that companies that do best do a great job with SEO, great organic search, and then also invest in the paid advertising. I met with a fellow from Home Depot last night, and it was interesting to have him say they had done their own research on that as well, and found that was in fact the case, that being great on SEO and being great on thoughtful, analytically driven paid advertising, the combination of those two yield the best results. So I think for companies that are investing in the power of search, optimizing around both of those is just a foundational part of being a great marketer.
Okay.
And the content part, I mean, content is such a critical part of having great great engagement by your customers, and there's so much lousy content. There's so much content and so much lousy content out there that I think the people who are really winning are focusing on having content that actually engages the customer and provokes them to action.
And as we heard from the prior guest, actually knowing what content that is, that you may or may not actually know
yep.
what is the page
right.
that's driving
so
it.
So power of insights matters a lot, right? Track that and determine for yourself what
right.
is the content that makes the biggest difference.
Well, Darren, thanks for stopping by. Good luck on your keynote. Good luck on your presentation, your panel, right?
Yep.
So again, Jeff Frick here on the ground, Sheridan Palace at the Bright Edge Share 14 conference.